side.
Come on!
How did we get here?
No! Look out!
Move!
I think I found his weak spot. Ready?
Do it!
Wait for it!
Now!
Resolving the paradox, Sarah and Noel defeat the rampaging giant Atlus. In the ensuing confluence of energies, they are suddenly transported to an entirely different location. The two find themselves standing on a rolling plain that Sarah recognizes as the steps of Grand Pulse. A thudding boom resonates through the air. They have heard heavy footfalls like these before. All around them are gigantic soldiers, man-made weapons of destruction. The final war, spoken of in the prophecies, has begun.
Colossal war once raged across the land. The spark was the pillar of cocoon, growing weaker by the day, threatening to collapse. Among the people, there were those who sought to resurrect the foul sea. They wanted to use their power to avert catastrophe. However, there were many who feared the foul sea and their part in Cocoon's history. The populace was split. Anger divided them. Over the course of time, the debate escalated. As the battle raged on, one side created soldiers the size of mountains. Instead of surrendering, their rivals retaliated by building their own massive weapons. What began as a dispute between humans became an earth-shattering war between giants. The titanic conflict grew beyond the people's ability to control. Pulse became a scorched battlefield. And eventually, what they set out to protect was destroyed.
That story has been passed down for generations. It happened long before I was born, but for Sarah, it's a war she knows nothing about, one that has yet to take place. The massive weapons of war overran the land. They say it was the beginning of the end of the world, the day the giants caused the fall of Cocoon. If it's true.
If we defeat all the giants, then we should be able to save the future, and the world. I've made up my mind. I'm staying here with you, Noel, in this time. I can't let the world be destroyed.
Thank you. thanks, Sarah. The pillar supporting Cocoon is already weak and starting to crumble. There's not much time left for us. But even so, we're not going to give up. We can't. Because I know what happens after Cocoon comes crashing down from the sky. The world is stripped of growth, of life. The water runs dry, and even the winds grow still. Everything withers away in a slow death. It's a world with no hope, no future, nothing. A forsaken world. That's the world in which I was born.
Ready?